What is up, you guys? This is Mini Superheroes Today.
And if you've been following along on my channel, you'll know that week by week leading up to Avengers Endgame, I'm doing a series where I'm showing you a showcase of customs, purist customs, that is, from every Marvel Cinematic Universe movie in chronological order of release leading up to Avengers Endgame. So, in today's video, we've gotten to Thor the Dark World. Man, I can't believe how long we've been on this road to Avengers Endgame, and we're not slowing down anytime soon. So, before we let too much time pass here, let me jump in and show you how to build the characters from Thor the Dark World using 100% official LEGO pieces. So, let's get started. Alright, so if we're doing Thor the Dark World, it only makes sense that we start off with the God of Thunder himself, the Mighty Thor. So for this figure, I used the Age of Ultron torso as the base. So that's the Age of Ultron torso. The head and the hair and the cape are from Age of Ultron, and so are the arms. The only real additions to this figure that I made are using my handcuff method, where I take a pair of handcuffs and I cut scissors right at the edges there to cut the chain out of the middle, and then I put the remaining handcuff piece on the wrists there just to add a little bulk or like gauntlets or things like that to just about any LEGO figure that it makes sense for. Of course, you'll need a Mjolnir hammer there, and then the only other change I did was I used the legs from one of the cops from the LEGO Batman movie accessory pack, and why I use those is because it's got a nice dark blue top that matches the torso, but then some black boots that just add a little bit of definition to the God of Thunder. So, now that we've done Thor, let's keep moving on and show you some other figures in this collection. Okay, so next up, we've got Loki from Thor the Dark World. Now, Loki had a really interesting arc in this movie. You know, he was imprisoned after the events of the first Avengers, and of course he gets out, and then he's impersonating Odin at the end. Spoiler alert. But in any case, here's my Dark World Loki design. I used the head from Loki from Ragnarok. I used the hair from Tassu Leech from the LEGO Star Wars Force Awakens Millennium Falcon. I used the dark green skinny cape. You'll notice it's skinnier here as opposed to some of the spongy capes we get these days. But the skinny cape is from the Mandarin from the Iron Man 3 sets. The torso is from Loki from the first Avengers film. I've just put some dark green arms on him with some tan hands to add some green accents to Loki, and then the legs are from Aquaman from the Justice League sets. So I really like having all of those dark green accents for Loki, and I think that it makes a really accurate look for Thor the Dark World. So let's move on to our next figure. Next up, we've got Jane Foster in her Asgardian attire. As you'll remember, Jane Foster gets kind of like, I guess, possessed or something by the ether, and they take her to Asgard to work on her, so that's what I represented here. So the hair is from Scarlet Witch from Captain America Civil War. It's that nice long flowing hair that looks like Natalie Portman's in Thor the Dark World. The face, speaking of Natalie Portman, is Padme from Star Wars Attack of the Clones. My philosophy is if a character or actor or actress already exists in another LEGO property, we might as well use them because nobody's gonna look more like Natalie Portman than Natalie Portman. So that's Padme's face. Then the torso, this arm, and the dress part are actually from Dumbledore from the Harry Potter collectible minifigure series. I think it works really well for Jane's Asgardian dress, but the only thing you'll want to do is pull off this arm and add a tan arm there because she doesn't have a sleeve on that arm. So with that, you'll have Jane from Thor the Dark World, and I really like the way that that figure turned out. And since I just showed you Thor's girlfriend, now I'm gonna show you the girl who should have been Thor's girlfriend, Sif. So, the hair is from the LEGO Ninjago sets. It's from this guy specifically. I don't remember what his name is, but it's from that guy. I really like that for Jamie Alexander's hair as Sif. The face is from Mantis, but you can also get that face from any, well, not any, but one of the Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom ACU troopers. I think that that face works really well. The torso is from Cyborg. If I flip it around, you can see the back of Cyborg's belt right there. So that's from Cyborg, and I really like the way that that contours. Even though it's the back of Cyborg, it actually kind of looks like female battle armor. Then you'll remember that Sif has her bottom parts of her arms showing. So I used the arms from Hyperion to show that she's got some red, armor on her arms there. Now, the one thing I will say is this shield is vintage. And if you remember my Thor showcase just on the first Thor movie, I used the same design for Sif there that I used here. and I don't have any other shields in this shape that don't have the vintage design on it, but if you do, then that would work perfect. So anyways, I know that that shield isn't 100% perfect, but bear with me. I gave her a Valkyrie sword. I think that that works well. And for the legs, I gave her Scarlet Witch's legs because, you know, I think that it's good because Valkyrie has a skirt and boots on. So that's a great way to show her shins there while showing that she has a skirt and boots on. So that's my design of Sif. Next up, we've got Captain America, and this may seem funny because this was the scene where Loki was impersonating Captain America. That was such a cool scene showing off Loki's shape-shifting powers, and it really set up a power move toward the end of the movie, so it was awesome. So to build this version of Captain America, you'll need the shield, the torso, and the legs from the first Avengers movie, Captain America, and then the head and the hair are from the Civil War Captain America from the Black Panther pursuit set where Cap didn't have a helmet on. Because as you'll remember in this cameo, Cap didn't have his mask on, so this figure shouldn't either. So this was one of my favorite cameos or little Easter eggs in any of the Marvel movies, so I definitely wanted to make sure that I represented it in Lego form for my Thor the Dark World showcase. So let's move on to the next figure. Next up, we've got Heimdall, and I'm using the same Heimdall design that I used for my Thor showcase because it's kind of hard to improve on that, and his costume didn't really change much, if at all. So the helmet is from the Lego Ninjago sets. It's from one of the older guys with the eye patch. Coincidentally, the same guy that I used for Odin, but I don't recall his name. But I think that that works well for having those horns on Heimdall's helmet. The head is from Mordo from the Doctor Strange set, from the Doctor Strange movie, that is. The armor plate is also from the same guy that this helmet came from, so if you get him, you can use that figure for Heimdall, and you can use it for Odin, because you'll need the head, but you'll see that in a moment here. The torso is from the Atlantis Guard from the Justice League sets. I popped some brown hands on there to match his head. I gave him this gold sword from Finn from the Lego Dimensions sets from Adventure Time. And then I used just some dark brown legs there just to give some contour and some accent to Heimdall. So this was a tough figure to design, but I am happy with the way it turned out, and hopefully you guys are happy with that as well. So since I was just talking about Odin so much in the last segment, I figured, hey, why not talk about him a little more now? So to build Odin, you'll need Doc Brown's hair from the Back to the Future set, the Lego Dimensions set, that is. And I like that because it's got that, you know, wise king long hair kind of deal going on. The head, as I said, from the Heimdall section is from this one character from Lego Ninjago, whose name I've never really learned, but in any case, that'll work well. And the reason you have to use that head is because the eye patch for Odin, of course, is on this eye, and this is one of the only Lego heads in existence, if not the only Lego head in existence that I could find, that has gray hair. There's a beard underneath the Santa beard here, and has the eye patch on that side of the head. So unfortunately, we don't have a ton of options, which is why he's got to have yellow skin. But as I said in my Thor review, I think that it works well because it makes sense for the oldest guy in the MCU, or one of the oldest guys, that is, to have yellow skin. It's like he came from a time before there were flesh-colored minifigures, so if anybody's gonna have yellow skin, it should be Odin, wouldn't you agree? So the torso is from Thor from Age of Ultron. I gave him some black arms. I used the handcuff method again. Once again, I put some yellow hands on him, and then I put Loki's legs from the Avengers on Odin. So I really like the way that Odin turned out. It's a really fun purist custom, and I hope that you guys liked it too. Next up, we've got Loki and Thor's mom, Frigga, who had a really sad death scene, but it was really meaningful and a really beautiful scene in this movie. So in any case, to build Frigga, you'll need the torso and the legs from one of the Harry Potter collectible minifigure professors. The arms are from one of the Atlantis guards, once again from the Justice League sets. And the head and the hair is from General Leia from Star Wars The Force Awakens. If you put all that together, I think you actually get a really accurate Frigga as far as using the purist method is concerned, and it gets two thumbs up from me. So let's move on to the next figure. So next up, we've got Eric Selvig, and for this figure, I actually used the same head and hair that I used in my Thor showcase, because he didn't really change all that much. The hair is from Doctor Who, and the head is from Han Solo from Star Wars The Force Awakens. I think that this face matches with the hair well, with the gray eyebrows and all of that. Then I just gave him some blue jeans on the bottom, and actually, Aunt May's torso from some of the Spider-Man sets works perfect to match Selvig's actual sweater in the movie. So as funny as that is, if you flip that around, it actually matches almost identically. I never, ever, ever would have thought that Selvig would wear Aunt May's clothes, but hey, the MCU is full of surprises, isn't it? All right, so next up, we've got the big bad guy of Thor: The Dark World, even though he wasn't that memorable and he wasn't even that menacing. But in any case, before I jump in, I do want to point out that I know that the face is from Two-Face from the Lego Batman sets, and I also know, as you can see in this image, that Malekith's burn is actually on this side of his face. So it is unfortunate that this face doesn't match up perfectly, and if I'm being totally honest, in a perfect world, I would have rather used this Shredder head from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, but at the end of the day, I don't have that head in my collection, and I wasn't able to get it in time for this video to special order it, so I hope that you guys can understand that in a perfect world, I would have rather used that head, but I've got to use the pieces that I've got here. So in any case, the hair that I used is from either one of the Wonder Twins from the Lego Batman Movie Collectible Minifigure Series 2. The head, as I said, is from Two-Face, but I actually recommend using Shredder even though I don't have that head. On the shoulders here, I used two shoulder pauldrons from the Death Trooper from the Star Wars Rogue One sets. I think that that just adds a nice little armored look to Malekith. I used black arms with black hands, also from the Death Troopers, so that'll be nice. You do need two Death Troopers, though, because the pauldrons don't go on both sides, so there's actually two pauldrons on there. Don't let me forget. And while I'm talking about the Death Troopers, the legs are also from the Death Troopers, and then the torso is from Jango Fett from Star Wars Attack of the Clones, but not the old one, the more recent one. So Malekith is by far 100% the hardest figure that I've had to design so far, so I hope that you guys can forgive me for not having that right head, but in any case, let's move on because I've got one more figure to show you. All right, so in the post-credit scene of Thor: The Dark World, the Warriors 3 go to the Collector on Nowhere to give him the Aether, because, as they say, it's not wise to keep two Infinity Stones together, and the Tesseract was already on Asgard. So with that, here's how to build the Collector. I used this cape from this woman from the Ninjago series, and I'm sorry guys, I'm not up on my Ninjago. Let me know in the comments below what her name is, but I think that it works for his eccentric cape. The torso is from Chancellor Palpatine from Star Wars Revenge of the Sith, but turned around. So if I move him, you can see Palpatine's torso on the back there, but I like that Argyle sweater look on the front if you flip that around. I just used some black legs with some black arms and white hands, and then I used three 1x1 pieces, black on top, black on bottom, and then a translucent red in the middle to build the Aether from Thor: The Dark World, so that's how you can build that prop. I used the white hair from the Lego set version of Doc Brown, but that hair has come in several places. And then I used the face from the Grandmaster because the Grandmaster and the Collector are brothers, so naturally they're gonna look kind of alike. So that's how I built the Collector. And before I do my final overlook, I just wanted to say, if you guys have the new Harry Potter sets that come with this new lantern mold, you could also put some red studs in there for an alternate design on the Aether. Just a thought that I had and wanted to share. Alright, and that is my showcase of Thor: The Dark World LEGO Purist Customs. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to hit that subscribe button so that you don't miss any more of these really fun showcases leading up to Avengers Endgame, and be sure to check out my other videos for other LEGO Purist Customs, and reviews, and news, and all that other fun LEGO stuff. So hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the comments below, and until next time, build on. If you liked what you saw and you liked what you heard, feel free to click that subscribe button for more LEGO content coming in the near future. So, thanks for tuning in to today's video, and until next time, build on.